So I've just described an interesting game, but in 2011, Lionel Levine came up with a totally different hats game, and very little is really known about this. Its distinctive feature is that all the players have infinitely many hats, each one of them equally likely to be blue or red. So here is just the beginning of infinitely many hats.
That would go all the way.
All the way up to the ceiling and through. And now, maybe if they get smaller, it will only have finite height. So now the game sounds pretty impossible. You have some number of players. Each player, of course, sees everybody else's stack, can see nothing about their stack. There was a strategy session. Each hat is equally likely to be blue or red. And what you do is name a number, 17. Everybody names a number simultaneously. There's no communication. And if all of those numbers are the position of a blue hat on everybody's head, even if they say different numbers, then you win.
Blue could also be a red hat?
Nope. I'm going to take, just to fix the way I think about it, it's going to be everybody has to have a blue hat. In fact, the case where the hats are the same color is really the same problem. And so, clearly, in this case, what does communication mean? It's true, I see your hats, you see mine, but we don't have other people. There's no correlation between our hat colors. So what are we talking about here? Well, if we both guess, you have a chance of one half of naming a number where there's a blue hat, and so do I. We have 1 in 4 chance of both being right. Our goal is to all be right. Here there are two players, so we both have to be right. Amazingly, there's a strategy that gives us better than 50-50. And now let me describe it. I look at your stack of hats, and I go to the first blue hat. And if you're very persnickety, you might say something like, what if they're all red? And my answer is, look it, they're all coin flips. Sooner or later, that will be a blue hat. And I say that number. In other words, I say, I have a blue hat there. And you do the same thing. You find the first blue hat on my head might be the first one. If it's the first one, you say number one. You're saying you have a blue hat. Again, this seems a bit peculiar. How can this be any better than a random guess? Well, we have to think carefully about that. You've named the position of the first blue hat in my head. I've named the position of the first blue hat in your head. Well, the referee starts just erasing the red hats. Our stacks come down until one of us has a blue hat. Really, what happens? How far down do the stacks go? There's 3 ways, all equally likely, that they can come down. Maybe the stacks both come down to blue hats. That means our lowest blue hats are in the same place. Equally likely, a blue hat comes down for you before me. Or the reverse. Maybe my first hat is blue, your first hat is red. That's the position where you're going to name, and I'm going to name, and we'd be wrong. Those 3 cases are equally likely. That means that our success chance is 1/3. Better than 1/4. If you think about it, in this game, much more has to go right when you have more players. It seems inevitable that the success probability is going down. And this is a game, a puzzle, where the answer is not known. However, let's just stick with 2 players. So what we know is that the winning probability is at least 1/3. Optimal winning probability, optimal strategy is at least 1/3. It's trivially at most a half.
Fumbling in the dark and guessing.
Yeah, well, forget my guess. Your guess is 50-50 being right. We're not going to do any better than that. Okay, what is this number? What is that number? Nobody knows. However, there's a conjecture. With a more complicated strategy than the one I said, you can get a probability of 7/20, or if you prefer, 35% of winning. That's a little better than 33 1/3%.
What does that algorithm even look like? What does that
strategy,
is it really complicated?
You know, people basically search for it on a computer. You can give a vaguely reasonable description. Nobody really understands it, though. And loosely speaking, it involves looking at 3 hats at a time, and then, in some sense, doing a table lookup. How could that be best possible? I mean, really. What about looking at more hats? It seems like you can prove an upper bound better than 1/2, namely 3/8. And you can actually improve this down to about 36%. So the answer is between 35 and something around 36%. And nobody has, with a lot of computer searching, found anything better than 35%. A lot of people are willing to guess that 35% is the best answer. Nobody knows how to prove it. And just to be really strange, in the case where there are a lot of players, although everybody believes that the optimal probability goes to zero, even if slowly, nobody knows how to prove that.
Still work to be done.
Still work to be done.
You better get to work.
Yeah. N people for large N, infinitely many hats. I don't have a clue.